What's the deal with nitrogen? Tires have air in them, right? Some tire dealers have started putting nitrogen in their tires. You can tell this by the green valve stem caps. Some dealers put a green ring around their valve stem, but most of them have a green valve stem cap if they're using nitrogen. Is this better or is it a gimmick? I'll let you decide. Since I'm sitting in front of my BF Goodrich truck tires, I'll tell you, BF Goodrich says nitrogen is simply dry air with the oxygen removed, and their tires will work with either nitrogen or air. Air is around 79% nitrogen already. So here's the pitch. Rubber is slightly porous. Nitrogen molecules are bigger than oxygen molecules. Well, at least a little bit. Very little, probably. Since nitrogen replaces the oxygen, less air can escape from your tires through the rubber in the tire, and the air pressure stays higher for longer. That is not the only point of air loss. There are other sources of leaks that molecule size doesn't affect. The tire rim interference point, the valve stem, around the valve stem and around the valve, the wheel. If nitrogen is dry air, what about moisture?
Moisture. Is dry air important? If it were, then we could simply use a filter. This is my filter rig for when I do automotive paint. We could use a 1 micron filter and remove all the moisture from the air. For normal driving, I'm saying no. For racing, where tire performance is critical, tire pressure and tire temperature may be more predictable with dry air. I don't know. Bottled nitrogen would be a good source of dry air.
Putting nitrogen in your tires is only a scam if you pay extra for it or if you go out of your way to get it.
Anyway, know that nitrogen and compressed air can be mixed if needed.